Hi viewers, assalamu alaikum. We are studying the dentin and we will start our today topic from the theories of pain transmission through dentin. These include the direct conduction theory, the transduction theory and the fluid or hydrodynamic theory. Direct conduction theory, in which the stimuli directly affect the nerve endings in the tubules. Transduction theory, in which the membrane of the odontoblast processes conduct an impulse to the nerve endings in the pre-dentin odontoblast zone and the pulp, while the fluid or hydrodynamic theory, in which the stimuli cause an inward or outward movement of the fluid in the tubule, which in turn produces movement of the odontoblast and its processes. The figure shows the theories of dentin sensitivity. The cell body of odontoblast present in the pulp and its processes are extended towards the dentin. The cell body is supplied by the nerves from the brain, the thalamus, as a perception center. Odontoblasts at the top explain the direct conduction theory, in which the stimuli directly affect the nerve endings in the tubules. The second odontoblast shows the transduction theory, in which the membrane of the odontoblast processes conduct an impulse to the nerve endings in the predentin odontoblast zone and the pulp. While odontoblast at the bottom of the figure explains the hydrodynamic theory, in which the stimuli cause an inward or outward movement of fluid in the tubule, which in turn produces movement of the odontoblast and its processes. Age and functional changes. Vitality of dentin. Odontoblast and its processes are an integral part of dentin, reacts to physiologic and pathologic stimuli. Reparative dentin, also known as tertiary or response dentin, if by extensive abrasion, erosion, caries or operative procedure, the odontoblast processes are exposed or cut, the odontoblast die or if they live, deposit reparative dentin. Origin of new odontoblast is from undifferentiated perivascular cell, has fewer and more twisted tubules than normal dentin. Sometimes a combination of osteodentin and tubular dentin is seen. Odontoblast lay down 1.4 micrometer per day. Regular secondary dentin occurs on the entire pulpal surface. In multi-rooted teeth, it is thicker on the roof and floor of the pulp chamber. The size of the pulp cavity decreases and obliteration of the pulp horns. The dentinal tubules change their direction to a more wavy course. The number of dentinal tubules are fewer, line of demarcation is dark. The figure shows the line of demarcation, the circumpulpal dentin and the response dentin. Irregular secondary dentin, reparative or tertiary dentin. It is formed as a result of the severe stimulus. The dentin is formed at a localized area. The dentinal tubules are less in number and irregular in arrangement. UMC from the subodontoblastic layer will differentiate and replace the degenerated odontoblast to form reparative dentin. Figure shows the odontoblast layer and the response dentin. Next figure also shows the irregular secondary dentin, reparative or tertiary dentin, and the irregular dentinal tubules. Here the figure A shows the carious dentin, the tertiary dentin and the innermost the pulp. The figure B shows the tertiary dentin, cellular inclusion, predentin and the pulp. The next figure shows the types of reparative dentin, the osteodentin in trapped cells, atubular dentin area without the dentinal tubules and the vasodentin entrapped by the blood vessels. Thus, secondary dentin may be regular, irregular. Cause for the formation of the regular secondary dentin is the mild stimuli, slow adhesion and slowly progressing caries, while for the irregular secondary dentin, severe stimulus, abrasion, erosion, severe adhesion and deep caries. Site of formation of the regular secondary dentin. It occurs on the entire pulpal surface of the tooth, thicker on the roof and floor of the pulp chamber in the multi-rooted teeth. While for the irregular secondary dentin, it is formed at the area corresponding to the pulpal end of the exposed dentin. Dentinal tubules. The dentinal tubules of the secondary regular dentin change their direction and have more wavy course. They decrease in number per unit area. The dentinal tubules of the irregular secondary dentin decrease in number and some areas may have no tubules, atubular dentin. In regular secondary dentin, line of demarcation is present and stain dark, while in the irregular secondary dentin, line of demarcation may or may not present. Clinical importance: decrease of the pulp chamber height and obliteration of the pulp horns make the liability of the pulp exposure during cavity preparation much less likely to occur. While in case of irregular secondary dentin, the localized area of dentin formation increases the time taken by the caries to reach the pulp barrier. Transparent sclerotic dentin. Mild stimulus leads to changes in the dentin already present. The figure A shows the odontoplast and its processes undergo fatty degeneration. While the two shows, then there will be calcification of the dentinal tubules, first become narrow by widening of the peritubular dentin, and the third shows that the dentinal tubules become obliterated. Affected area have occluded dentinal tubules, so the dentin have uniform refractive index, so this area of dentin appear translucent by transmitting light. The figure shows the transparent dentin. As we have studied earlier, the affected area have occluded dentinal tubules, so the dentin have uniform refractive index, so this area of dentin appear translucent by transmitted light. Dead tracts. Severe stimulation to dentin leads to destruction of the odontoblastic processes and odontoblast. This leads to the empty and wide dentinal tubules. Here shows the dead tracts. The black area shows the localized inflammation and edema. Is compared with the non-inflamed pulp. These areas appear black with the transmitted light. Under the dead tracts from the pulpal surface, reparative dentin will be formed. The dead tracts surrounded by the sclerotic dentin are also shown in the figure. The figure shows the enamel, dentin, pulp, ameloblast, odontoblast, pulp, sclerotic dentin, and dentinal tubules. Here the figure shows the dead tracts surrounded by the sclerotic dentin. Classification of dentin on the basis of location, pattern of mineralization, and developmental pattern. First, we are studying on the basis of location. Basis of location, dentin is divided into intertubular dentin, intratubular dentin, mantle dentin, and the circumpulpal dentin. Intertubular dentin is formed around and between the dentinal tubules. Intratubular dentin found and formed within dentinal tubules, also called peritubular dentin. Mantle dentin formed initially in the crown, outer coronal dentin. Circumpulpal dentin nearest to the pulp, formed in crown after mantle dentin has been deposited. The next classification is on the basis of pattern of mineralization. On the basis of pattern of mineralization, dentin is divided in two. Globular dentin, interglobular dentin, Thoms granular layer, and sclerotic dentin. Globular dentin, formed from calcospherites. Interglobular dentin, hypomineralized dentin, between the mantle and the circumpulpal dentin, normally only found in the coronal dentin. Thoms granular layer, hypomineralized layer in the root dentin, similar to the interglobular dentin in crown. Sclerotic dentin hypermineralized, occluding intratubular dentin. Now the classification on the basis of developmental pattern. On the basis of developmental pattern, dentin is divided into primary dentin, secondary dentin, tertiary dentin. Primary dentin, formed prior to and during active eruption. Secondary dentin, formed when the tooth first comes in occlusion. Tertiary dentin, formed as a result of pathologic response, may be reactionary or reparative. Here the figure shows some types of dentin: sclerotic dentin, reparative dentin, circumpulpal dentin, sclerotic root dentin, reparative dentin. Dead tracts, erosion, and the crown atrium are also shown in the figure. Clinical consideration of dentin. The rapid penetration and spread of caries in the dentin is the result of the tubule system in the dentin. Dentinal tubules form a passage for invading bacteria that may thus reach the pulp through a thick dentinal layer. Driven cutting instruments cause dislodgement of the odontoblast from the periphery of the pulp and their aspiration within the dentinal tubule. Sensitivity of the dentin is also important, and effect of smear layer should be considered. Smear layer is a layer of microcrystalline and organic particles. Debris that is found spread on the root canal walls after root canal instrumentation. Infected dentin is the outer layer and is softened and contaminated with bacteria. It is reversibly denatured and not remineralized. Infected dentin has demineralized face but not yet invaded by bacteria. It can be remineralized. In clinical restorative treatment of dentin during cavity preparation, it is infected dentin which is completely removed. The affected dentin may be remineralized after the completion of restorative treatment, is not removed and is preserved. Aries affected dentin interface show a much thicker hybrid layer than was seen with the non-carious dentin. Presumably, the thicker hybrid layer in the caries affected dentin may be due to the fact that caries affected dentin is partially demineralized. More porous than non-carious dentin allow deeper penetration of the acid etchant, leading to a deeper demineralization with diffuse monomer. Figure shows the dentin development, odontoplast differentiation. The next figure shows the early dentin formation, dental pulp, pre-dentin, ameloblast, enamel, stratum intermedium are shown. Thank you so much for watching the video and don't forget to subscribe the channel.